All right, so you need to build an app, and you've heard about this Flutter thing and made your way here. Maybe you have some wireframes or some sketches of what you want your app to look like, or you're just getting started. Regardless of what brought you here, welcome. Hi, I'm Fitz, and I'm going to be helping you through the process of building apps in Flutter. Even though you're here and on the other side of the screen, I can still hear you saying, okay, so I know Flutter is a thing you can use to build apps, but what is it exactly? Thank you for asking. That's a great place to start. Flutter is a toolkit for building apps. Like a real-life toolkit, it has many of the fundamental things you need to construct something. Screwdrivers, hammers, drills, and on up through more specialized tools are all part of a standard toolkit. And if you were building a house, you probably wouldn't start by building your own screwdriver or hammer. Similarly, Flutter provides many of those foundational things for you. We call them widgets. In Flutter, it's said that everything is a widget, and these so-called widgets are the building blocks for any Flutter app. There are title bars, columns, lists of other widgets, buttons, icons, text input boxes, and even the Flutter logo itself. Everything is a widget to the point where most of them themselves are made up of other widgets, even your app itself. So let's consider an analogy. Suppose you wanted to write a book. After sketching out the story arc, the characters and their relationships, the setting, you start to write. But you don't just write a book. You consider which words to use, how they fit into sentences, how those fit into paragraphs or sections, and how they're composed together to form chapters, which together form the book. And thus, you end up with a hierarchy of components. A book is composed of chapters. Chapters are composed of paragraphs, paragraphs of sentences, sentences of words, words of letters and punctuation, all the way down to pixels or dried up drops of ink smoothed together to form the syllables we see on the page. But this exact pattern isn't strictly required. A chapter doesn't just have paragraphs. It might, for example, start with a quote, which is really just a stylized sentence. And there are lots of different presentations of a sentence. One character might speak exclusively in all caps. The title of a book someone picked up might be in italics, or a song might be presented as short sentences arranged like a poem instead of a paragraph. Flutter's widgets are much the same. You can combine and customize these common building blocks in new and interesting ways to form your own unique app. Take the app bar widget as an example, which is the header bar for many apps. It is composed of other widgets. It delegates the responsibility of handling text to the text widget, or button icons to the icon button widget. In this way, just like the various parts of a book, we end up building a hierarchy of widgets. As we go down the hierarchy, we get more specialized. The app bar's title is the text widget, which in turn is composed of widgets specializing in different aspects of handling text, all the way down to the handling of dropping pixels of ink onto the screen. And if we went the other direction, up the hierarchy, widgets get more abstract and more complex. An app bar is typically within a scaffold, which is itself some kind of app, like a material app, which in this case provides the basis for an app following the material design system. By putting widgets together in different arrangements, we can do all kinds of different apps, from simple to-do list apps to complex multimedia and project management apps, or really just about anything you can imagine. So with that in mind, let's go to actually building an app. How about a space exploration planning app? And all of these good space exploration planning apps out there really have two things. All of the different ones that I've seen have these two things: a progress indicator telling us how close we are to exploring the entire universe, and a checklist of things remaining to discover. And so your first step is really to sketch out what this app could look like. And as you do that, you might start to see some common elements. Text for the labels, checkboxes for the to-do list, an app bar for the title of the app up top. And there are existing widgets for all of these things, and so all you have to do is throw them together into an app, right? But where in the app? And how does a widget know where it needs to be on the screen? Remember that widgets exist in a hierarchy of relationships to other widgets. They have parents, children, siblings, nibblings, grand nibblings. And so when you're looking at an app's sketch, trying to figure out which widgets your app will need, also think about the relationships between them. If you look at this sketch again and consider the meaning of each section, you might start to see some groups. As the most generic, of course, is the entirety of the app. And the app bar is kind of its own distinct thing at the top with the title, and it's just kind of a distinct section from the main part of the app, which seems itself to have a section near the top that indicates our progress and a list of things to do underneath it, which itself is made up to-do items, and each of these groups needs to be arranged or laid out in a different way. The app at the very top follows a similar structure as most apps, but we have a list of widgets, or widgets that are vertically oriented, or widgets that are laid out horizontally, like the to-do items. And so when widgets are composed together to make apps, not all of them are things like buttons, icons, or text. When we say that everything is a widget, it also applies to layout, as in where and how things appear on the screen in relationship to other widgets. For example, there's a widget responsible for arranging other widgets one after another from top to bottom. It happens to be called Column, and its responsibility is to take its children and put them in a vertical layout. Back on the sketch of this app, you could then start to add in some of the layout widgets too, like to say that the progress section could actually be a column composed of a text and a progress indicator, or that a to-do item is in a row, and knowing which one of these widgets to use gets easier with practice, but let's start with what we know so far. All Flutter apps are written in the Dart programming language. If you don't know Dart, don't worry. Most of what we write at first is just mixing widgets together in different ways, and we'll slowly add in new Dart features as we go. Like in many programming languages, the main source file for a Flutter app starts with two things: a list of things the app depends on, and the main function. The material part of the framework gives you just about everything you need to start off with. For this introductory app, the only thing we'll need to import is that library. And as the starting point for the app, main just needs to do one thing. It needs to run the app. RunApp is a method from the Flutter framework and takes whatever widget you give it and puts it at the very top of that app's hierarchy of widgets. It's what we'll call the root of the widget tree. From there, we could just put our entire app into RunApp and build our way down the widget tree, but something feels kind of off about this. It's nice to have everything in one place, but it's generally considered good code quality to break things up and encapsulate different ideas or functionality into different things. This relates to a concept in software engineering called separation of concerns, where every component in a system is responsible for its own little part of the world and nothing else. Fortunately, Flutter has a construct for what one of these little things can be, a widget. And you can create your own by creating a new class extending from stateless widget. And we'll get to what that stateless part means in the next video. Every widget needs to have one method in it. The build method describes how to build this widget as described in terms of other widgets. Notice how build's return type is a widget. From there, we can build up our app using progressively smaller widgets, which we identified from the sketch earlier. Many apps start off with a material app up top and then split out the home page as a separate widget. This is a great point to run the app and see what it looks like. And of course, there's nothing in the code to say that this is any more than an app, so there's nothing there. So we can add in the scaffold, a widget which provides some of the common app patterns, throw in an app bar and the page titles, and start to construct the body. For the most part, all the widgets I talked about earlier just kind of fall in line. The whole body is a column and the two subgroups we defined. First, the progress section. This custom widget is similarly defined, and progress is just a text label and, because I like lines, a linear progress indicator underneath it. The task list has a couple more layers to it, and right now I'll define it as a column whose children are task items, and in order to maximize the reusability of this widget, I'll have it take in a parameter for its label, and then it itself will just be a row with a checkbox and a text that we discussed earlier. And there you have it. It's not much, but it's a solid start to your first app in Flutter. Before we part ways, you may have noticed in the last couple of minutes that I only clicked on the run button once. Yet the app magically updated as we added things? There's no cinema magic or sleight of hand here. This is all due to a feature called hot reload, which picks up many different kinds of code changes and updates the running app with the new code. We'll dive a bit into this in the next video. Until then, we covered a lot in this one. what Flutter is, how you can build apps by combining widgets in different ways, and then saw how it all comes together in real code. But I also left some unanswered questions. What is the state in a stateless widget? Why is the checkbox not checking when I tap it? And how can we make this app actually look good? Check out the description below for additional readings that go into more depth on some of the things covered in this video, and then I'll see you in the next one to start tackling some of those questions.